Hi students, welcome back to my another video. Today I am going to give you some easy tricks to solve KP and KC. It is from the equilibrium chapter from NCERT. It is from chemical equilibrium. If you stay tuned up to till end, you can easily solve the problems by seeing the tricks and by seeing the tricks how you are going to solve the problem in examination. So be stay tuned till end. Now I am going to give you some easy tricks. Trick number one. Trick one. To solve the equilibrium constant, suppose if reaction is A to B. If the reaction is A to B, equilibrium constant is K. Suppose the K constant is given as 38. You should write directly 38. Any number, if it is given, you can write directly. It is forward reaction. Suppose if the reaction is given like this, reverse reaction, B to A, the equilibrium constant is 1 by 38, like this, reverse reaction. Reverse reaction, you should write, backward reaction, K is equals to 1 by 38. Now, trick 2. Trick 2 is, so if the reaction is A to B, to find the equilibrium constant, if the reaction is A to B, suppose K1 is 10. The number is the 10. Then the n factor of A to B. N factor of A to B. This is K2. Then you should write K1 to the power of n. You should write K1 to the power of n. If instead of n, the number is 2A given to B. Then the equilibrium constant is K2 10 to the power of 2. What I have given? 10. K1 is 10, then 10 to the power of 2. If the reaction is half of A, then gives to half of B, then K2 is 10 to the power of 1 by 2. As I said, if the reaction is A to B, then the equilibrium constant is 10. If the reaction is given as NA to NB, then the reaction is K2 is equal to K to the power of N. Instead of stoichiometric ratio, the ratio is given anything, N is equals to 1, 2, 3, 0, anything, then half of A to the B gives 10 to the power of N. Now moving to trick number 3. If the reaction is given A to B, equilibrium constant is K1. Then B to C, equilibrium constant is K2. If the two reactions are given, you should find A to C. If the reaction is given A to C, find K3. You should find K3, then you should multiply the equilibrium constant. You should multiply or you should add the reaction. If you add the reaction, BB get cancelled, you will get A to C, K3, you will get the value K3 is equals to K1 into K2. You should do multiplication. Now, trick number 4. Moving to trick number 4, finding the KP and KC. To find KP and KC, if the reaction is A plus B gives C plus D. If the reaction is A plus B gives C plus D, therefore equilibrium constant is equals to the ratio of concentration of product to the concentration of reactant. As I said, equilibrium constant is equals to the ratio of concentration of product to concentration of reactant. Then the if taking this reaction, you will get concentration of C into concentration of D by concentration of A into concentration of B. If the stoichiometric ratio is given 2A plus B or 3 gives 3C plus D, then the equation becomes Kc is equals to C raised to 3 and A raised to 2. Like this you should write. In terms of partial pressure, in terms of partial pressure, you should write partial pressure of C into partial pressure of D by partial pressure of A into partial pressure of B. If the stoichiometric ratios are 2 plus 3B gives 4D. If the stoichiometric ratio are 2A plus 3B gives 4D, then 2A means PA raised to 2 and 3B PB raised to 3, then PD raised to 4. You should write like this. Moving to trick 5. Students, you can easily solve if you remember this type of tricks. So moving to trick 5, suppose K is very high. Suppose K is equals to 1000. Taking the value of K is greater than or equal to 10 to the power of 3. It is given in textbook, NCERT, or you can write, you can take 10 raised to 2 also. Then the concentration of product is greater than at equilibrium is greater than concentration of reactant at equilibrium. As I said, K is equals to 1000 or 1000 by 1, then it becomes concentration of product at equilibrium is greater than concentration of reactant at equilibrium. Here reaction is almost completed. Here the reaction is almost completed. Therefore, degree of dissociation is denoted as X. Degree of dissociation is high. Degree of dissociation is high. Now, if K is very less, if K is very less or low, then K is equals to 1 by 1000. It favors reverse reaction or backward reaction, then concentration of reactant at equilibrium is greater than concentration of product at equilibrium. As I said, it favors backward reaction. If K is very high, it favors forward reaction. If K is equals to 1. It favors both forward as well as backward reaction at a time. Don't worry, students. After giving all the tricks, I am going to solve the numericals. How you are going to solve the numerical, I will show to solve easily by using the tricks. So now moving to trick 6. 6, trick 6, KC and KP, KC and KP. The KP is equals to KC RT to the power of delta NG. If delta NG is number of product minus number of moles of reactant, you should do this one. R is 0.0821, or you can write 1 by 12. Better you substitute in the problem, 1 by 12 is easily you can calculate. If you use the decimal, it is bit difficult to calculate the problems in numerical. So use 1 by 12. Use 1 by 12 to calculate the R value in numericals. If Kp is equals to Kc RT to the power of delta Ng, if Kc is not given, if Kc is not given in problem, if Kc is not given in problem, if Kc is not given in problem, better you go for partial pressure of individual component is equals to mole fraction of individual component, partial pressure of total component. Go for this one. Mole fraction of A is given as number of A moles of A upon total number of A moles of A particles. We should go for this. Now moving to the tricks. Now moving to the last trick, trick 7. Trick 7. Last trick is trick 7. If the reaction is in the form of A plus B gives C plus D. The all is in the form of liquids. Only it favors Kc. Only you should calculate the Kc. Here no need to calculate, it does not come Kp to calculate, only you should calculate Kc. Remember this, don't forget, only if it is, the reaction is in the form of liquid. L is given, that it favors only Kc. Seeing this, all the tricks, you can easily calculate how to calculate the all problems in examination. Here, in equilibrium chapter, the weightage of the problems are nearly 4 to 5. In chemical equilibrium, the main topics you should follow this degree of dissociation and this, what I said, this one. Tricks to solve Kp and Kc. Kp and Kc. As I show the tricks to follow this Kp and Kc in this video, so stay tuned till end. I'm going to solve some problems. You can easily understand how to solve the problem in the exam point of view, in the NEET point of view or JEE, any exam in, you can follow these tricks to solve. Because easily you can score 4 marks here. You can score 4 marks here. You can't get any difficulty to find in the reaction in this. So in next video, I'm going to give this degree of dissociation, how to calculate. So now moving to solve the problems. Now the problem is, the equilibrium constants of the following are, here given N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3K12. K1 is given. N2 plus O2 gives 2NO K2 is given, H2 plus half O2, H2O, K3 is given. The equilibrium constant K of the reaction, you should find the equilibrium constant K. The given reaction is 2NH3, 5 by 2O2 gives 2NO plus 3H2O will be. You should find the K value here. The reaction you see here in the product, 2NO. 2NO is K2. Here given is, this is K2. Right? K2 is given. Now, plus 3H2O. Here is given is K3. Here given is K3. Right? K3 is given. How many moles of stoichiometric ratio are there? 3 moles. As I said, if given any K, n is equals to 3, then raised to 3. You should follow this trick. Trick number 2, you should follow raised to 3. K2, K3. And seeing the reactant side, here given is 2NH3. 2NH3 is K1. As I said, for the backward reaction, if B gives A, then you should follow 1 by K. You should follow this trick. Trick number 1, you should follow then by K1. You should follow K2, K3 raised to 3 by K1. Then the options are here, this one. The option is this one. K2, K3 raised to 3 by K1. See students, how it is to do all easy problem. So you can go through the problems like this in equilibrium chapter. You can easily get 4 marks. You won't miss the marks here. It is from the model paper 2017, previous year paper. You can go through this like this problems in model papers. You can solve the question papers easily. Now going to the next question. If the equilibrium constants for N2 plus O2 gives 2NO, is the K the constant for half N2 plus half O2 gives NO will be? You should find the K, equilibrium constant you should find. Here the options are K to the power of 1 by 2, half K, K and K square. The reaction is given here like this, half N2 plus half O2 gives NO. You should find the K value here. You should find K value here. Here given the, what I said, if the reaction A to B or A plus B gives C plus D. As I said in trick 3 or trick 4, half B gives half of C or C plus D, anything. Then the K value is K1 is K to the power of 1 by on n. As I said, K to the power of n, then half is K to the power of 1 by 2. Right? Here the equation is half, stoichiometry ratio is half, here also half, the N2 plus O2 is then NA plus NB. Here the value of n is half, then the stoichiometry ratio K to the power of 1 by 2. Easily you can find. See, the option is K to the power of 1 by 2. See the students here how to find easily. So stay tuned till end. Now I am going to give another question to solve you easily. So stay tuned. Now moving to another question. If K1, K2 are the respective equilibrium constant for the reaction is given here. You can see. Next, the equilibrium constant for the reaction, you should find XeO4 plus 2HF gives XeO3F2 plus H2O. Here you should find the equilibrium constant. You should find here the equilibrium constant. Here seeing in product XeO3F2 is in the product, that is K2. This is K2 and this is K1. This is K2 and K1. In the reaction, what is given? XeO3F2 means here the given is K2. Here the reaction is K2. Now H2O. H2O in the product form is given. Here XeO4 XeO4 is given in the reaction. XeO4 is in product 1, in the reaction K1. Is going back to the reverse reaction here. A to B is given, or B to A. As I said, if A to B is given, you should write directly K. If B to A reverse reaction, you should write 1 by K. Then K2 by K1. Easily you got it, student? K2 by K1. Then the option is K2 by K1. This is K2 by K1. Easily you can find like this by using the tricks. Moving to the other reaction, to find Kp value here is given in the question. For the reaction C plus O2 use 2 CO, the partial pressure of the CO2 and CO are given 2.0 and 4.0 atmosphere respectively at equilibrium. What is the value of Kp? You should find the value of Kp. As I said in last week, Kp is equals to partial pressure of component into partial pressure of product, right? Partial pressure of product upon partial pressure of reactant. If I have taken the equation A plus B gives C plus D. For this, we will write like this. So, to find the value of, here given the reaction, you should not take solid form, you should cross this, and taking the oxygen, partial pressure of CO and CO2. You should find the partial pressure of CO2 and CO. Then Kp is equals to partial pressure of CO. How many CO is there? 2. Raised to 2, then partial pressure of CO2. Here partial pressure of CO, what is given the value? 2 raised to 2. Right? Here partial pressure of 2 and 4 atmosphere respectively. See this. Partial pressure of CO, 2 moles is given, raised to 2. Then 2 moles means 4. 4 raised to here this one. 4 raised to 2. Then partial pressure of CO2 is 2. Here given, see, partial pressure of CO2 is 2 and CO is 4. Then 4 raised to 2 is 16 by 2. 2 ones are 2 eights are. What is the value? 8. You should find like this. See, student, how easily you can find? You can solve the many problems. Easily you can, 4 marks here. You won't miss the problem in the examination. Now moving to other question. For the gaseous reaction, 3H2 plus N2 gives 2NH3. The equilibrium pressure of N2 are 0.4 and 0.8 atmosphere respectively. The total vapor pressure of the equilibrium system is 2.8 atmosphere. The value of Kp. You should find the value of Kp here. The given equation is 3H2 plus N2 gives 2NH3. The given equation is 3H2 plus N2 is 2NH3. The equilibrium pressure of N2 is equilibrium pressure of H2 and N2 are 0.4 and 0.8. Here 0.4 plus 0.8. Right? 0.4 and 0.8 plus x. We don't know the value of 2NH3. Here, if you add this, you will get 1.2. What is given? 2.8. What is given? Equilibrium system is 2.8. 1.2 plus x is equals to 2.8. Then x is equals to x is equals to 1.6. The value of x is 1.6. The value of x is 1.6. Finding the partial pressure. Finding the partial pressure Kp. Kp is equals to partial pressure of NH3 upon partial pressure of H2 raised to 3 into partial pressure of N2. What is given partial pressure of NH3 is 1.6. 1.6 is given. 1.6, how many moles are there? 2 moles, right? 2 moles of NH3 then raised to 2. Partial pressure of H2 is 0.4 raised to 3 into 0.8. If you solve this, you can get 50. If you solve this, you can get 50. The Kp value under partial pressure is 50. The option is 1. See students, how easy to solve the partial pressure problems Kp and Kc. If you want to get more videos like this, subscribe my channel, like and share, and stay tuned up to the end. So before now, only the 15 days are remain for your examination. So practice more and more model papers and previous question paper, and all the best for your examination.